if you want to become Android developer, then you need to understand that just learning Android is not going to make you Android developer. Because in order to learn that particular Android development, you need to have something else. That is, you need to have little bit high specs laptop. So having high specs laptop means it will cost you a little bit of money. Yes, of course, after you become Android developer and when you go for some job, you'll be able to get that money back. But in order to start learning Android, you need to have really good specs of laptop, at least 16 GB RAM. Having 8 GB of RAM is going to make you so much trouble in terms of running Android application. And if you are thinking about running some kind of emulator in it, then forget about it. And also, if you want to become iOS developer, then obviously you need to have Mac device. You don't need to have iPhone, that is going to cost you more money, but you need to have at least MacBook Air or Pro, that is going to cost you at least 60 or 70 thousand, depending upon what variant you are going for and how much discount it's having at that particular moment. So just understand that in order to become Android developer, you need to invest on your device also. Yes, of course, you can buy Apple device and you can do Android development. That's why I'm talking about iOS development also with this. Once you have device, you can then start working on it and you can start learning Android. But getting that particular device, it's going to cost you a little bit big amount of money to you, first of all. Then once you start with it, it's going to take much time for in order to Android things to get installed on your laptop. And once everything is installed, then you might get weird error related to SDK or Gradle, depending upon what kind of technology you are using in Android. Maybe if you are using React Native, then there will be some NPM related things also. If you are using Flutter, then you need to learn about that also. So overall, you have to learn Android Studio also. But that and all are like advanced topics. In order to just start learning it, you need to have good laptop. And once you have it, you need to have a little bit of patience inside you, saying like it's going to take a little bit time. So that's one of the biggest hurdle in order to become Android developer. Once you pass that particular hurdle and you start searching for the job, you will obviously get a job, because lots of these big companies are there, right? They will require Android developer. And if somebody says that Android development doesn't have that much demand, that means yeah, it doesn't have that much demand as maybe like React or Node.js developer, but demand which exists in that particular field is going to pay you like little bit more amount of money only, because lots of people can learn Node.js or React easily by using their 4 GB or 8 GB laptop. But in order to become Android developer, you need to have 8 to 16 GB of RAM and good specification in your laptop. And when you invest that much big amount of money in your laptop, that time obviously you will be able to learn something unique which other people cannot learn. That skill is going to make you get little bit better job. That obviously this app development jobs are really good paying jobs. Now if you say that you have to use web technologies like React Native or even Flutter in order to build Android application, what about main core Android, that is using Kotlin or Jetpack? Nowadays I think they are using Jetpack in it. So yeah, Jetpack works on Kotlin only, so you have to write Kotlin code inside it only. That's why in order to learn that particular thing, is there that much demand? Yes, because lots of these big companies, they use native application or they have some kind of native component inside it, which is required even if they are using some kind of other things. So if you are interested in native development, so obviously you can go ahead and start it. But try to look into all these frameworks like React Native and Flutter also, so you won't miss out latest market opportunities available out there. So if you have option, learn these other frameworks also. But if you don't have, then still it's fine if you learn just Kotlin, or even if you learn Java and you can incorporate that knowledge into Kotlin and build Android application, that's also fine. Once you learned Android development with your high specs laptop and you go for some job related to Android, and when you are getting salary and when you are working in these cutting edge technologies in your company, that time obviously you will feel worth becoming Android developer. So if you are not at in that particular stage, then if you are trying to become some kind of Android developer, or if you are interested in Android development, then I would highly recommend you to like start trying it. But even though I know that entering Android is little bit tough because of laptop specs and all those things. Somehow, if you are able to manage it and if you learn it properly, then you will be able to find good job, and that job is going to pay you really good amount of money. I have some of my friends who work in Android based product company. So these apps which you use on your phone, like Swiggy, Zomato, and so all those are Android apps, and they need Android developers in their company. So if you have that knowledge, then obviously you will be able to try those companies. So that's it for this video, guys. If you like this video, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. And see you in the next video. Bye bye.